to those I leave behind. I live in the suburbs of suburbia, and like it or not, my story is splattered across this city. I had my first kiss and my first heartbreak here. My church is only a block from my home, and I know all the back roads like the veins on the back of my hand. I learned to ride my bike on the street in front of the house I still live in. My brothers learn on the same sidewalk I played hopscotch on. Neighbors have come and gone, but I still know all their names. Wonder about all their fates, but I do it under the same streetlights I've walked home under since I was 5, under constellations I name after them. The sidewalk knows my name and the trees whisper my secrets, but I cover my ears because even I don't want to know. I've learned the secrets of these streets, how to walk along them unnoticed or be the only thing people see. This city does a lot of talking. The hallways of my high school will tell you all our deepest fears, the way none of us want to die here, and how if you listen close enough when we walk, you can figure out who is already hollow from the echoes we make against beige cement. The library can tell you why I'm afraid of boys who come up behind me, and the lunchroom can point out all the kids who don't fit in. The streets are big gossips in this town. The curbs will tell you exactly how many times I've stood on them without taking a step forward, and how many times I have. They will tell you how many scraped knees have fallen upon them as we rode our bikes for the first time. In the buildings you can hear echoes, back corridors where I cried alone, or dark school buildings where our laughter echoes after hours, when games of tag were only more fun in the dark, but be careful in the light. Those hours were not always as joyful. Our graveyards are some of the best storytellers you'll ever meet. As a child, I played hide and seek there, or walked from stone to stone, and imagined whole lives of those who now lay underground. We played together, even inviting the disciples depicted in the middle. They were some of my favorite playmates, because even if they weren't real, they seemed to be. At least the one I went there to see to begin with. The wind will tell you how many times I have cried at that cemetery, how many people I've ever brought there, and it will tell you that is where my dad lays. But the trees will whisper that I still won't stay, because I won't. My story is splattered across this town, but by God, it is not where it ends. This concrete knows my secrets, and so it knows my footsteps will cease to walk upon it. The people here are family, but I still can't stay. The city is home. It always will be, but it's never felt that way. I've been stuck, splattering randomly at signs of discovery, looking for freedom in sidewalk cracks and dirt pathways. I'm hoping that I'll find that somewhere when I leave. Please forgive me. P.S. I'll still love you. Signed, me, a girl who hopes you know I'll take you with me when I go. Thank you.
Subscribe for more.